Hello friends, in this video, I am going to discuss first type of kinematic chain and its inversion, that is 4-bar chain. So 4-bar chain is called a mechanism where one link is fixed, and if we are fixing more than one link in 4-bar chain mechanism, so it will become inversion. So let's start the discussion of 4-bar chain mechanism and its inversion. So 4-bar chain, here I am going to discuss when 4 links are joined together and it is forming a turning pair, so that is called 4-bar chain. Now if we talk about 4-bar chain mechanism, so if one link of 4-bar chain is fixed, so it will convert into 4-bar chain mechanism, and it is also called quadratic cycle chain or quadratic cycle chain mechanism. When no link is fixed, so it will be a chain. So it will be quadratic cycle chain or 4-bar chain. When one link is fixed in this particular kinematic chain, so it will become 4-bar chain or quadratic cycle chain mechanism. So here we can define this 4-bar chain as kinematic chain with 4 binary links and 4 kinematic pairs. So any kinematic chain with 4 number of binary links and 4 number of kinematic pair, as well as 4 number of turning pair and 4 number of joints. So this particular chain is called 4-bar chain, and here if we are fixing one link, so it will become 4-bar chain mechanism. Here we have this particular 4-bar chain, and this is the simplest type of kinematic chain, which is having number of degree of freedom 1. And so as per this concept, here there are 4 number of links AB, BC, CD and AD, and each links are joined together and it is forming turning pair. So with 4 number of links, we will form 4 turning pair or 4 kinematic pair. So AB and BC are forming one pair, BC and CD are forming another turning pair, CD and AD is forming another turning pair, and AD and AB is forming another turning pair. Here this turning pair we generally define on the basis of these 4 joints. So this is a 4-bar chain. Now if we are fixing one link AB, so it will convert into 4-bar chain mechanism. Now if we talk about inversions, so here, if more than one link is fixed in this 4-bar chain mechanism, so this will convert into inversion. For example, if we are fixing this BC link, so this BC link is fixed and AB link is fixed. So here, more than one link is fixed, so this particular mechanism will convert into inversion to define other types of mechanism for transmission of motion. The motion can be transmitted from rotary motion to reciprocating motion, or rotary motion to oscillating motion, or vice versa. So this inversion we generally define two different types of mechanism. So in this 4-bar mechanism, if we are considering one link, and as we know, number of degree of freedom for this 4-bar mechanism is 1. And this number of degree of freedom we generally define by one variable, theta. It means the shortest link generally move with angle theta, and it can complete one revolution. Like this theta, we can consider it is equals to 360 degree. So if we are considering theta equals to 360 degree, in that case, this crank or this shortest link is also called crank. So it will complete one circle or one revolution like this. It will complete one revolution. So here we can consider with the change value of theta, it will represent the rotation or it will represent the movability of link CD and BC. So this shortest link should have 1 degree of freedom on the basis of angle theta, and so this shortest link should have different value of theta, and this complete revolution is necessary for this shortest link to define the rotation or to define the movement or motion of link CD and BC. Here in this four bar mechanism, we can define a Grashof law, which is generally representing the relative position and motion of different link involved in four bar mechanism. So as per the Grashof law, we are considering four link in four bar mechanism. So as per the Grashof law, we can consider sum of the shortest link and the longest link length should not be greater than sum of the length of other two lengths when links are in relative motion. Here we are considering one shortest link as AD, that is the crank, and which is in motion by angle theta, and another link if we are considering AB. So if we are considering AD as the smallest link and AB as the longest link, so the summation of shortest link and longest link should not be greater than summation of other two links which are in contact and which are in relative motion with these two other links. Here AB link is fixed, so it will not be in relative motion. So the relative motion of these two links CD and BC is defined by the motion of AD. And here if this AD is moving a complete revolution, if the value of theta equals to 360, so this condition is the worth condition to define the rotation or to define the motion of CD and BC. So as per the Grashof law, the sum of the shortest link and longest link AD plus AB, we are considering sum of the shortest link and the longest link, it should not be greater than, so here it can be equal to the summation of other two links length CD and BC. So this particular condition we can consider as per the Grashof law. If it is not greater, so it can be equal or it can be less. So here we will consider the identical condition, that is AD plus AB, that is equals to CD plus BC. So this is representing the Grashof law for this four bar chain and four bar chain mechanism. Now here, as I said, we are considering AD as the shortest link and the rotation of AD is responsible to define the motion of CD and BC because AB link is fixed. So basically AD we can consider as driver. Because this AD is driving the other link. AB link is fixed, and if this AD will complete a revolution, if link AD is completing a circle, in that case, this link CD will also move with link AD, as well as this BC will also move or it will oscillate with AD. In that case, AD link is driving the other link CD and BC. So AD we can consider as driver. And here this AD link is rotating, so this rotation is responsible for oscillation of link BC. So here we can consider rotary motion is converting into oscillating motion. So this BC link we can say it is a follower or rocker, and this link CD is in contact with link AD and BC both. So it is connecting basically AD and BC. So this link CD we can say a coupler. and this link AB is fixed, so it is called frame. So as per the Grashof law, AD plus AB, that is equals to CD plus BC. And the point which you have to remember, if we are considering AD as a crank or the driver and it is moving with angle theta, so the complete revolution generally represent the motion of link CD and BC, and the complete revolution should be 360 degree to define the relative motion of CD and BC. If it is not equals to one revolution or one complete circle or 360 degree, so this particular condition, we can say it is useless condition. It will not define the complete relative motion of CD and BC. So the complete revolution should be here, theta will be 360 degree to define the relative motion of other two links. And these are the terms which we are using for all other links. AD is the driver, BC is the follower or rocker, because we are considering oscillation in BC because of this driver AD or rotation of driver AD. And this CD link will also oscillate, but it will act as a coupler between BC and AD. And since AB is fixed, so it is called frame. Now let's discuss different inversion of four bar mechanism or four bar chain. So if we talk about inversion, so in that case, in kinematic chain, if we are fixing one link, so it will become a mechanism. But if different links in the kinematic chain are fixed to define different types of mechanism, so it is called inversion. So here, if we are considering a particular kinematic chain, which is the combination of different number of link, it is not necessary that number of link should be four only. But if it is four, so it is called four bar chain, or if one link is fixed, so it is called four bar chain mechanism. So here, our basic consideration is four bar chain. So here we will consider maximum four number of links. For five bar chain mechanism or for six bar chain mechanism, there are other different mechanism which I'll discuss in next lessons, but here I'm going to discuss four bar chain and four bar chain mechanism inversion only. Now here the first term which I'm going to discuss, which is called beam engine. So it is a inversion of four bar chain, and this beam engine is also called crank lever mechanism or crank and lever mechanism. Basically, there are two parts we are considering. One is the crank and another is the levers. That is why it is called crank lever mechanism. And this is the first inversion of four bar chain or four bar chain mechanism. As we know, four bar chain mechanism we generally use to convert rotary motion into oscillating motion or reciprocating motion. So here we are considering four number of link in beam engine or crank lever mechanism, where two main parts are crank and lever. So here you can see one link is fixed. This particular base we are considering as link one, which is fixed. And here one more part we are considering, that is cylinder or piston cylinder arrangement. Now this fixed link is connected with one driver, or it is called crank. So this AB link we are considering as crank. This link AB we are considering as crank. Now this AB is connected with another link, link 3. That link we can consider as connecting rod. So this link 3 we are considering as connecting rod, and this link 3 is further connected with lever, and which is pivoted at point D. This is the joint we are considering for this lever, and it is again connected with this fixed link 1, because this particular part is fixed with link 1. So here we have now three parts. First, fixed link 1, next crank, that is rotating about point A. Another link is connecting rod, and this connecting rod is fixed with this lever. So how many links we have here? Here we have four links. Link 1, which is fixed. Link 2, that is crank. Link 3 is connecting rod, and link 4 is lever. And here at point C, this lever is connected with this link 3, and at another point we are considering in this lever. So this particular point is connected with a piston and piston rod, where this piston is moving inside the cylinder, and this cylinder is also fixed. So here number of links are fixed. So this is called the inversion of four bar chain. Here chain we are considering with four number of link, but number of parts which are given here are fixed. That is why it is called inversion. So your cylinder is fixed, this particular part is fixed, and base is fixed. Now how this particular mechanism or inversion of four bar chain mechanism or beam engine generally work? So basically here, if we are considering this shortest link, that is the driver, or it is called crank. So when this crank will move, or it will complete a revolution here, this particular circle is representing a complete revolution of crank. So when this crank will complete revolution, theta equals to 360 degree, in that case, if this crank is moving in this direction, or in anti-clockwise direction, or in clockwise direction, in that case this particular link 3 will oscillate with the rotation of link AB, or shortest link AB. And when this link 3 oscillate, so it will also move this lever. So lever, when this link is moving anti-clockwise, so this connecting rod will go upside and it will move lever like this. In that case, this point C will move upside and this point E will move downside, and this particular lever will oscillate about this point D. This particular lever will move, it depends on the rotation of crank. If it is in anti-clockwise direction, so this lever will move this piston in downward direction, because here when this connecting rod will moving in upward direction, so point C will move in this direction, upward direction, and this point E will move in downward direction. And with the help of this particular point E, this piston rod, with the help of piston rod, because point E is connected with piston rod, so this point E will push the piston in downward direction. So here, whatever fluid we are considering, or whatever gas we are considering inside the cylinder, so this piston will compress this particular fluid inside the cylinder. So by this way, this beam engine works. Now when this crank is moving in opposite direction, so this link 3 will also move in opposite direction, and here this point C, at this particular point, this point C will also move in opposite direction, and point E will goes in upward direction. So it will move piston and piston rod in upward direction. So it will be responsible for the expansion of this particular fluid or gas inside the cylinder. So it depends on the rotation of the crank, or the direction of rotation of the crank. Here this link, shortest link crank, is generally defining the relative motion of each and every link in this four bar chain mechanism, or inversion of four bar chain mechanism. So basically here, rotation of crank is converting into reciprocating motion. So this rotation of crank is responsible for reciprocating motion of piston inside the cylinder. So this is called inversion of four bar chain, or it is called beam engine. Now next type of inversion of four bar chain is coupling rod or locomotive. It is also called double crank mechanism, because it generally has two crank which rotate about two different points. In this diagram, here you can see this link AB. This is the link AB and it is rotating about one point A. And it will complete one revolution about point A only. Similarly, in double crank mechanism, we will consider two links which rotate about two different points, and there should be one complete revolution for crank to define the relative motion of other links. So here you can see this coupling rod of locomotive. This is called double crank mechanism, and here we are considering four links. Link one, which is the fixed link, and it is fixed at point A and B. Point A and B are representing the joints. And here we are considering two links, link 2 and link 4, BC and AD, which is representing the crank. So here, two cranks we are considering, and these two cranks are connected with link 3. Here you can see this is the link 3, and these two cranks are in contact with two wheels. Here you can see this red circle are representing the wheels for the locomotive. Now here one link is fixed, which is generally representing the fixed distance between the center. It is generally useful to fix the distance between the center. If it is not fixed, so it will not fix the distance between the center. So it should be fixed. So here we are considering this is the inversion where different link are fixed, and two cranks we are considering which are responsible for rotation of these two wheels. Here one wheel or one crank will transfer the rotation to another wheel. And this link 3 we are considering as a coupler because it is joining AD and BC. So here, as I told you, the crank should complete one revolution for defining the motion or relative motion of other links. So here, if we are considering AD as the driver, so this particular AD will move in a particular direction, like in this direction we are considering, which is defined by the variable theta. And if it is completing one revolution, so when it revolves in this direction or when it rotates in this direction, so it will give the motion to link 3. So because of the rotation of the crank, this particular link 3 will oscillate, and this rotation we will consider about point A. This AD will rotate about point A, and this rotation will give motion to link 3. This will oscillate and it will transfer this motion to another crank on another link BC, and this particular link BC will also rotate in the same direction, and it will also complete one revolution because AD and BC we are considering of equal length. So if AD is equals to BC, and AD and BC we are considering radius of the circle, so when AD will complete one revolution and it will transfer the motion to link 3, that is connecting rod, so it will oscillate and it will again transfer this rotation into rotation of another crank, and this crank will rotate second wheel. So here we are considering this kind of inversion to convert or to transfer the rotary motion from one crank to another crank. Now, next type of inversion which I am going to discuss, that is Watt's indicator mechanism. So this Watt's indicator mechanism is also called double lever mechanism. Here we are using two lever, like previous inversion, there we have considered two cranks. Now here we will consider two lever, that is why it is called double lever mechanism. So this is what indicator mechanism. This is the complete diagram with the motion. Here we are considering different parts and different links. So first part which we are considering as a fixed part, that is one indicator cylinder, and inside this indicator cylinder we are considering plunger, and inside this cylinder there is one gas or one fluid filled, and this particular plunger will move with the help of one rod. This is called the piston rod, or we can say the rod which is attached with the plunger. So inside the cylinder there is a gas filled, and when this piston rod moves up and down, so the pressure inside the cylinder will increase or decrease. There will be compression and expansion possible because of the motion of this piston rod up and down. And how this particular piston and piston rod will move up and down? Here it is connected with four links. Here we are considering four link in what indicator, and the first link which we are considering is fixed link. So this fixed link we are considering, and from this fixed link, link 2 is connected. So this we are considering as the lever. So this link 2, here we are marking all the points A, B, C, D, E. So this AC link we are considering as one link. AC is one link. Now from point C, there is another link which is connected, and this CE link, it is connected at point C and it is forming a turning pair. So first link we are considering link 1, that is fixed link, and from this fixed link, one point at point A, there is one lever is connected, that is AC, and from point C there is a link CE connected, and another point we are considering this point E, which is the second point of this particular what indicator mechanism. Now another link, fourth link we are considering, that is BFD. Here we are not considering separate link BF and FD. Here this BFD is one link because there is no relative motion between BF and FD, and this particular link E will move upward and downward when this particular link AC will rotate about point A. So here, as we know, if we are considering AC link and this link is rotating with angle theta, and that theta angle if we are considering with this straight line AE, this AE is a straight line. Now after rotation of this link 2, link 1 is fixed, so this link 2 will rotate about point A. So this can be considered as a crank, and this can be considered as a lever also, but here we are considering this link AC as the rotating link. If we are not considering as rotating link, in that condition it can move like a lever, but if we are considering this particular link AC as a crank, so it will rotate with angle theta and it will complete one revolution, that is theta equals to 360 degree. So when it will rotate with angle theta, in that case we have this another link, BFD link. So this BFD link, as I told you, it is a fixed link, so this will also act as a lever, and it is further connected with link CE. So this link CE will also move or oscillate with this rotation of link AC. So this CE will also considerable as lever. So here we are considering two lever basically, BFD, that is a lever, and CE, that is a lever, and link AC we are considering as rotating link. And when this link 2 rotate, in that case this particular point E will move upward, because we are considering this as a lever, so it will move upward. And when this point E will move upward, so it is connected with other two links. It is connected with BFD link. So this point D will also move upward with respect to point E, because point E is also moving upward because of the rotation of point C. Because point C we are considering here. Now, if it is forming a circle, so because of change position of point C, this C dash position, so this particular C dash will moving upward direction because of the rotation, or it is forming a circle. In that case, all other points will also change its position. So when C is increasing or C is changing its position to C dash, in that case point E will also move upward. And this point D will also change its position, so it is changing D dash. And this point F is also change its position. So now, when point F is moving upward because of the rotation of link 2, in that case, this particular plunger will move in upward direction. Now, if it is completing one revolution and this link 2 is trying to complete one revolution and it is coming back to its original position, and because of that, this point E will also comes to its original position. In that case, this plunger will goes down. So when plunger will goes up and goes down because of the rotation of link 2 and change position of lever or link 3 and link 4 and change position of point F, so we can consider here compression and expansion process of this particular gas inside the cylinder. So whatever displacement we are considering for BFD, because BFD is a single link, here BF and FD, we are not considering separate link. So there is a no relative motion between BF and FD. So BFD will be considerable as a single link. So this BFD is in contact with this plunger. Now, if F position will change, so it will change the position of this plunger in upward and downward direction. So we can say whatever displacement we are considering in BFD link, it will be directly proportional to pressure of the gas or pressure of the fluid which is inside the cylinder. Because compression and expansion process mainly occur because of the movement of piston rod, upward and downward movement of piston rod, and this motion is possible only when this F point is changing its position, and this F point will change only its position when there is a rotation of this link 2 is possible. And when rotation of the link 2 is possible, in that case all other points like the CE will convert its position into CE dash. So every link is connected with each other. So rotation is converting into reciprocating motion in this particular Watt indicator mechanism. So this is all about 4-bar chain or 4-bar mechanism, Grashof law, and different inversions of 4-bar chain mechanism. Thank you so much.